Some people don't know how to differentiate rocks from minerals. If
Chris,
you're
watching. Chris, start over.
Oh, okay.
Scene two. Take
it. Some people don't know how to differentiate rocks from minerals, and if you're watching this video, you're probably one of them. According to my computer, rocks and minerals are very, very different. A rock could be composed of many different smaller minerals or mineraloids, while minerals are typically found within rocks. For example, compare rocks and minerals to a cake and its ingredients. Let's think about it like this. A nice big old cake is a rock. To make the cake, you of course need your ingredients. Now each ingredient brings up something unique to make the cake to make it complete. In this situation, the ingredients are the minerals. The ingredients are just a small part, but when they come together, they will produce something much better, which is the cake. For now, there are a couple ways to define minerals. For one, minerals must be solid. Even their rocks and many other substances are solid. If it doesn't match the qualifications to be a mineral, then it isn't a mineral. Minerals must occur in nature and have a chemical composition that can be definable. Minerals also have a crystalline structure and must be inorganic. Important words to know while identifying minerals are cleavage, which is the splitting rocks or crystals, luster, which is the shine or description of different kind of minerals, streak, observed color, scratch on a white tile, and hardness, relative resistance of a mineral scratching, or how hard the mineral is on the most hardness scale. Color, property of an object of different sensations. Congratulations, now you know how to define a mineral and tell it apart from a regular old rock.